Let's talk about X-Pro3. It is a purist camera, it is a perfect photographic camera, or what is with this Fujifilm X-Pro3? Hi there, my name is Tudor Matescu, and in this video I will talk about X-Pro3 after using it for at least 1 year. Please subscribe to my channel for more videos and photography gear talk and tips. So, I've bought this Fujifilm at least 1 year ago. I wanted to sell it a month ago. And I decided I will not sell it. Why? Because I love it. I love it. It's a perfect camera. It's a perfect camera for me, for lots of reasons. It's a purist camera. It's a content marketer, creator camera. It's an analog camera. It's a camera that can do a lot of stuff. Yes, it has some quirks. You have with this camera a love and a hate relationship, but with what person that you love, you don't have a love-hate relationship. So it's a camera with a personality. It's a camera that it makes you tick. It's a camera that it really inspires you. It's a camera that it allows you to make a lot of photography styles, and this is very important. With this camera, I can do digital photography, I can do analog style photography, I can do fast photography, I can do slow photography, I can do product photography, I can do kids photography, I can do weddings photography, I can do bad weather photography. I can do a lot of stuff with this camera, and it's very, very competent. I can do low light photography, I can do by day photography, I can do interior photography. It has the power to be able to deliver in any kind of situation. It also looks very good. It also inspires you. It has all the dials and whistles that you want on the camera. It really doesn't bother me because it doesn't have an IBIS, image in body stabilization, because for this kind of camera, I don't want it. This is not a camera that you will take snapshots. No, this is a camera that is forcing you to think about composition. Even if you use the tilting screen like this or using the viewfinder. And let's talk about the viewfinder. The viewfinder, it's amazing. It's effectively amazing. The electronic viewfinder, the optical viewfinder, the little patch that it's helping you to make the manual focusing by using the optical viewfinder. You can do a lot of stuff with this camera that I really don't see people talk about it, and I must make eventually another video about what you can do with this camera. And also we have some lenses, or at least one manual focus lens from Voigtlander 35mm f1.4 that will work with this camera, being a FX mount natively that will transmit the settings, so you will have that parallax correction, you will have the frame lines moving in your optical viewfinder showing you what you are framing. This is very important. So you can use this camera like a Leica MD camera with Voigtlander 35mm f1.4, and you get good quality. No, you don't get full frame quality, but you get good quality. You can use this lens with Viltrox lenses that are giving you the Leica look, the vintage look, having auto-focusing system. You can use this camera with 23mm f1.4. What a look! You can use this camera with 35mm f1.4. And again, what a look! You can use it with Viltrox 56mm and so on, with all kind of lenses, and you get amazing RAW files and amazing JPEG files. The JPEGs, I've published a video with JPEGs right from this camera, my Ilford recipe. They are amazing. I really don't have to do anything to those files. If you are shooting with that recipe by day with good light, in night photography you must pump up the ISO, so you would be better if you use the RAW files in a post-processor in Adobe Lightroom or Capture One. But you get good right of the camera JPEGs, black and white. Also you get classic chrome, classic nags, all the recipes that Fujifilm are provided, and all the recipes are shown here, da? The film recipe that you are using. It's not a gimmick, it's something that is really working. You take the camera, oh, okay, I'm on black and white, good. I'm on my Ilford recipe, okay, I will do this kind of recipe. Oh no, I want color photography. Okay, you know, you don't have to look. Don't have to look, you just take the camera, put it at your eye, and you are focusing, and you are taking the pictures. And if you want that joy to see the picture after you finalized your photo work, after you finalized the photo shoot, let's say a family photo shoot, not a professional photo shoot where you want to check the pictures, but you can check the pictures very easy by flipping the screen or looking in the viewfinder. The joy that you get, it's an amazing joy. It's like using a film camera. You really get that joy. You just have to have a little patience and don't use the tilting screen. Just use the optical viewfinder, take the picture that you want and take pictures. Try to focus on the composition and on the state of flow that you are in, on the mojo that you are having in that day. And after finalizing, take the card, look at your photography at your computer. You'll be amazed by the quality. And if you don't have the patience, you can download the photos on your mobile phone. I've associated this button with Wi-Fi, and I really don't have to work the menus. I just press the Wi-Fi button, connect the camera to my phone, and download the photos that I've made. And when I'm looking at the photos on the big screen or on the mobile phone, after not looking at them at all, it's amazing when I see them, when I see they are looking good. I have the right highlights, I have the right shadows, I have the right contrast, I have the right grain, I have the right sharpness, and I have the right composition. I was able to take that photo. How Henri Cartier-Bresson said, the joy of photography, it's an intellectual joy. When the mind, the eye, the intellect, and the camera are coming all together, and when pressing the shot, you get the picture that you don't have to crop in. This camera offers you that joy. Of course, with this tilting screen, I've had some problems because when I'm not in the mood to take the camera at the eye level, and when I'm stressed, and when I don't have the courage, when I'm a little off with the stick photography game, of course it's hard. It's hard to pick the camera and look through the viewfinder. But I use the horizontal tilt screen, and if I see a vertical photography and I really want that photograph, I really get it, I use the optical viewfinder or the electronic viewfinder. But this optical viewfinder and this electronic viewfinder and this pain with the screen force me to make better compositions, and I really get better compositions by using this camera. Why? Because the peripheral view, when using the optical viewfinder, it's blocked, so I'm thinking only about the composition, and always I get better compositions by using the electronic viewfinder or the optical viewfinder. Also, using the optical viewfinder with a 35mm lens or a 50mm lens, 75 equivalent on the full frame, or an 85mm lens, and so on, a longer lens, it offers, it is helping me to be detached from the subject that I'm taking the photograph. So I know that person that I'm taking the photographs or that I'm using it to make the composition is not so close to me. If I would have used the electronic viewfinder, that electronic viewfinder would magnify and would have that electronic viewfinder is showing me just the entire frame. And I don't see behind, on the left, on the right, on the top of the frame. And I feel that subject is in my face. But when using the optical viewfinder, when using the range finder style of this camera, I feel that that person is not in my face. I don't feel like invading the privacy. And I'm calm about it. And also knowing that I have some distance from that person, 10 meters, 5 meters, and so on. This is very important. Also, by using the rangefinder optical viewfinder, you see in your frame when somebody will enter and you see things in real life. So you can really anticipate better than using an electronic viewfinder. It also has an amazing continuous focusing speed. You can fire 30, 40 frames per second. So you can use this camera at sports events, at weddings, and so on. It's an amazing camera. I really think it is better than Leica MD by having the autofocusing, by having this tilting screen. I really think that Fuji made it right. They told us well that you must use this camera and you must use it at least 6 months, an year to get it. Yes, you must use this camera at least 1 year to get it. Yes, you will have a love relationship with this screen, but I really do feel that this X-Pro3 made me a better photographer by forcing me to think more about composition, by forcing me to using the electronic viewfinder or the optical viewfinder. When I use this camera, I have some of the best composition I've ever made. They are very, very well made. So I really do recommend this camera if you want to be a better photographer. And you must be prepared at least 1 year to use it. You must have courage to overcome your fears when using this camera. If you do photography and if you understand photography, if you understand street photography, you must overcome your fears. And this camera will force you to do that. And this is the right way to do photography. Take the camera at the eye level. Use the optical viewfinder or the electronic viewfinder. In some situation when you have strong sunlight, you can use the electronic viewfinder. And it's another an amazing option that you don't have on a film camera. By night, the electronic viewfinder, it's amazing. So, I really do recommend this camera if you want to up your game. I really think it's an improvement of X-Pro2 because it is a next level. It is a next step. X-Pro2, okay, it was like XE4, X100V now. If you want X-Pro2 upgrade, you can buy XE4. Put the grip, put a leather case, put the thumb grip and you will have X-Pro2 version 2, something like that. But if you want a camera that can do it all, and this year I can do it, how I've said, you can do analog photography, digital photography, product photography, wedding photography, and so on. And this tool will also improve your composition, will improve your skill, will force you to overcome your fears, then choose X-Pro3. You will really not regret it. The only thing that I don't like, it's not having a Fujifilm full frame camera in such a small body with such small lenses. But the ergonomy, the quality, it is there. And with the new lenses from Fujifilm, the upgraded lenses, 20mm f1.4, 30mm f1.4, 18mm f1.4, and hopefully 56mm f1.2, a new version, with 50mm f1.0, you will have a very, very good camera system that you can do a lot with it. So choose X-Pro3 for the reason that I've talked about it. Please subscribe to my channel and talk to you soon. Bye bye.